历经千辛万苦长途跋涉，中南美洲移民冒着生命危险来到美国。
I came fleeing the violence in Mexico. Coming here, my eyes were shut, and I came blindly to try and build a new life for my family.
For many migrants, coming to the United States is less about searching for a dream than it is escaping a nightmare.
众多移民为了逃离自己国家的内乱，选择北上，非法跨越格兰河，进入德州，寻求梦中的 American Dream. 但没想到，对偷渡的孩童来说，这个美梦可能变成一场噩梦。这些非法移民儿童往往被迫沦为童工，在美国鸡肉加工厂违法工作。有些人一上班就是12个小时，而且工作环境充满危机。
In September, the Department of Labor raided 2 poultry plants owned by Exclusive Poultry, finding the company had employed children as young as 14 years old to debone chickens, wield sharp knives, and operate power-driven forklifts.
The knives. Yeah, one time I actually poked at myself. Just my finger went through the metal glove.
眼前这位现年18岁的少女，从16岁开始就在鸡肉加工厂上大夜班。她接受 CNN 访问时要求匿名，因为生怕遭到老板报复、扣留薪水，甚至解雇。
If we go to the agricultural area of California, there's hundreds of children working there. Or in the restaurant, in the garment industry, we have to change that mindset that it only happens outside the U.S. No, there's labor exploitation on children here in the United States. And it happens every day, everywhere.
美国曾在1990年代初立法，防止儿童遭受劳动剥削，影响到他们上学的权利。在立法之后，美国童工数量的确有所下降，但根据美国劳工局数据显示，从2019年后，童工人数又暴增88%。光是在2023年，全美国就有将近6000名孩童非法工作。劳工部官员透露，他们正在调查800起涉嫌剥削童工的相关案件。
We were able to identify and confirm 102 minors at 13 different plants in 8 different states.
Do you believe that 102 is the full extent?
Not at all. I believe that the number is likely much higher.
They're taking advantage of workers that adults probably don't want to do these jobs in some cases.
专家认为，童工数量之所以会激增，是由于拉丁美洲、亚洲部分地区的农村因为贫苦偷渡到美国。加上新冠疫情后，美国人工成本暴涨，而且劳动力又老化，进而找上未成年。
这里的童工大多是来自中美洲的移民，家境贫穷，肉类加工厂环境差，工作又累又危险。但移民童工别无选择，只能打黑工补贴家用。
这些孩童很少是合法移民，入境美国后通常会被转介给第三方就业机构，包套提供住宿和工作机会。不过这些小孩经常积欠生活费，他们就利用债务束缚逼迫这些小朋友去工作。由于酬劳低的可怜，根本没有还清债务的那一天。
Lawmakers in at least 10 states have either introduced or passed laws weakening child labor protections in the past 2 years, extending the hours minors can work, eliminating permits, and allowing employment in potentially dangerous industries like meatpacking and construction.
保护童工的法条越来越宽松，联邦政府更难取缔非法业者。
And the state is also saying, if you cross the line and violate those federal protections,Here at the state level, we're certainly not going to do anything about it.
就算被联邦劳工局开罚，罚款金额对这些大型企业来说根本不痛不痒。
根据美国现行法律，非法雇佣一名童工的最高民事罚款仅为1.5万美元，约合人民币10万元。如果一名童工在工作中受重伤或死亡，罚款上限竟然仅不到6.9万美元。
除了美国之外，根据国际劳工组织统计，全球大约有1.6亿名童工，也就代表每10位孩童中就有一个小孩被迫放弃受教育机会，沦为童工补贴家用。他们的受教权值得国际关注。TVBS 新闻综合报道。
想看最完整的新闻内容，记得下载 TVBS 新闻网 APP。